Business math percents. There are three parts to a percent problem. The first is the base, which is the whole quantity or total amount. The part, which is a portion of the base. And the third component of a percent problem is the rate. It's generally expressed as a percentage. So to solve a percentage problem, the key thing is to identify the given information. So here we have an example that states in the administrative assistant program at Southwest Tech, there are 18 students, 12 of them, or about 67%, reside in Grant County. So we're asked to identify what information given here is the base, the part, and the rate. And if we look at this and pull out the information, base is the total quantity that corresponds with the 18 students, implied the total number of students in this program. To identify the part, that's a portion of the total amount, and they're talking about 12 of these students. The rate is always the easiest to find. It's the percentage, and clearly 67% would be the rate in this particular problem. Here's another example. There's nothing to solve. We are just asked to identify the three components to the percent problem. Dave is a salesperson paid on a commission rate of 7%. Last week, his weekly sales were $21,500, so he earned $1,505. So when we're looking for the base, we're looking for the total amount. That sounds like his total weekly sales, $21,500. The part is the portion of that total, and that's what his commission is based on, his earnings, $1,505. Again, the rate is the easiest to identify because it's the percentage, and obviously 7% is the rate. Some hints when we're solving percent problems, as I previously mentioned, the rate is always going to have the percent sign, or at least the verbiage that's saying it's a percentage. The other hint that's very helpful is once you've found the rate, it's usually followed by the word of, and the number after the word of is almost always the base. And here's a very scaled down generic problem. 50 out of 60 is 83.3%. In this problem, we can identify the components using this hint. Here's our percentage, the rate. What follows the word of is our base, and the only other number that we haven't identified is the part. Here's another example. 45 is 90% of 50, and if we identify those components, the easiest one to identify is the rate as a percentage. Following the word of is going to be our base, and that leaves 45 as the part. So let's take a look now that we can identify the three components for solving a percent problem. Here are the three versions for solving a percentage problem. You may be asked to solve for part, and it's found by taking base times rate. We may be asked to solve for base if we're given part and rate, so we'd need to take part divided by rate. And the third possibility for a percent problem is that they're asking us what the rate is, where we will take part divided by base. In any percent problem, they will have to give you two of the three components in order to solve the problem. This relationship is also illustrated here in this circle where, given this arrangement, if we're solving for the part and you cover up or black out the part, it leaves base right next to rate, which means we're going to multiply base times rate. And you can see that relationship here. If you're solving for the base, black out or cover up the base, that leaves P over R, or part divided by rate. And if you notice, here's the formula that we had. And likewise, if we're solving for rate, cover up this portion, that leaves P over B, or part divided by base, and that's the formula that we have here. So one-stop shopping using this circle instead of having these three variations of the percent formulas. So let's take a look at solving a problem. 20% of cars in the upper parking lot are blue. If there are 135 cars in the lot, how many are blue? What are they asking us for? They're asking us for how many are blue. We see a percentage there. They're implying a total of 135, so we're looking for a part. And if we use this circle formula and we cover a part, that leaves us with base next to rate, in other words, base times rate. Replacing those values with the numbers from the problem, we have 135 times 20%. Convert that 20% into the equivalent decimal by moving the decimal place 2 to the left and multiplying. So the answer, how many are blue, would be 27 for this problem. In this example, it has a person took the written portion of their driver's test. She got 30 out of 35 correct. What is her score expressed as a percent? In the question, they're asking us, what is the percent? So we're looking for the rate. If we go to the formula circle, cover up the rate, that leaves P over B, which means we're going to take part divided by base to solve for rate. Plugging in the information, it's talking about she got 30 out of 35. The 35 sounds like the total amount or the base, leaving us with 30 as the part. Now when you do your division, 30 divided by 35, you end up with a decimal. Rate in a percentage problem is expressed as a percent, so we need to move the decimal place 2 to the right to have an equivalent percentage. And if we do some rounding, we'll give an answer of 85.7%. This problem has, on a day when it snowed heavily, 33 people, which is 55% of a company's total workforce, made it to work on time. What is the size of the company's workforce? We have our rate because of the percentage. The 33 will hold off just a minute, but it says 55% of a company's total workforce. The value following the word of is the base generally. They're asking it the size of the company's workforce. It appears we're looking for the base. How do we solve for base? If you cover up base in this circle, for our relationship in the components of a percent problem, it leaves part over rate, meaning we're going to take the part divided by rate. The part is the 33, our rate is 55%. Again, when you have your percentage, convert that into a decimal for ease in calculating and do your division. So it appears the size of this company was 60. When we have generic problems, it works basically the same way. Here in this example, 18% of what number is 900? The percentage is our rate. If we use that hint, the number following the word of is our base, and that's what the question is. So we're looking for the base. How do you solve the base? The relationship is P over R when we cover up the base in our formula circle, meaning we're going to take part divided by rate. Again, convert that percentage into the equivalent decimal, do your division, and our answer is 5,000. Another example, what percent of 40 is 30? There is no percentage. The question is asking what is the percentage, so we're looking for the rate. The number following the word of is our base, and leaving the 30 as our part. To solve for rate, if you cover up rate, that means we'll take part divided by base, 30 divided by 40, which gives us a decimal. We want our rate as a percentage, so we'll move the decimal 2 to the right, giving us 75% for our answer. One more generic percent problem, 22% of 650 is what number? Using our hints, we're given the rate, the number following the word of is base, so it appears we're looking for part. To solve for part, covering up part on the top, that leaves B next to R, which means we're going to multiply those values, and we have a percentage, convert that into its equivalent decimal, and multiply. So the part is 143.